So we're riding bikes on our way to Angkor Wat. Buddhist. And it's going to be good fun. It's a little while. Me and Dad were rented our bikes on the from the hotel. So yeah, we go haven't ridden bike in about many years. I don't know how many years. But oh, I'm coming up to an intersection, so I'm going to stop this. So I'll see you later on. So we're on our way to Angkor Wat, which is one of the wonders of the world. Big, beautiful temple. It's absolutely massive. It's got a counterpart, Angkor Thom, which we'll be going on later today as well, which has a 100-meter wide moat. And then after that, we'll be going to one of the temples that they filmed Tomb Raider in, where she was walking through the ruins with the roots spilling over the ruins, and she falls through the floor. But yeah, so we're going there. So first off, Angkor Wat. They have the best lights in Vietnam and Cambodia. They count down from both green and red, so Natalie can't stack. Brilliant. So here at Angkor Wat, the big temple, the biggest, one of the wonders of the world, is the entrance. So I'll be taking you through this today. I don't know how much footage I'm going to get because it's a massive place. So it might come in a couple of different separate vlogs. So I'll see you inside. So we're in the inner sanctum of the Angkor Wat. That's where we started. Up there, that's where we came in. And this is the actual temple itself. So it took us a good 10 minutes to walk down here. It's huge. So we've entered the temple, and they've all around the temple they're telling a story through carvings on the wall and different stories. So I'll show you portions of each section of the wall. So this is the first one. This is a battle against two tribes or nations.
Soldiers.
Yeah, so they're the
foot soldiers going up via ranks. The chariot with the bow and arrow.
This is absolutely massive. It starts from over there, all the way to the end. Very, very detailed. Yeah. The polish is from people touching it. Be worn down. And I think is the clash. Arrows through his head. This is the opposing side. So that one was called the Battle of Kurukshetra. Forgive me. But yeah, so that was the battle between the Kuruvas and the Pandavas. So I think I'm going to give a bit of an intro into each bas relief as we go along. So, changing that now. The next one, showing the army of Suryavaram II. You can tell I'm not Asian. So that shows his army, and I'll show you him as well. And then as we go along, it shows the Khmer troops, which are very much, Khmer is the Cambodians, which are much more disorderly and out of time and all that sort of thing. So I'll show you that.
Le roi a essayé de trop d'avoir. On a le droit.
Okay, so that's the leader.
So you can go out around here, our toilet over there.
Okay, don't worry, it doesn't matter.
Never again. So this section shows the difference between heaven and hell. I think it was 37 heavens, 37 heavens and 32 hells. And so it depicts people going from midsection, and then they split up to heaven and hell. So this is the 18-armed Yama, and he's basically the decider of if you go to heaven or hell. He's the their version of Saint Peter. So right here, he's got the people coming in, and he's telling them whether to go in heaven, up top, or down to hell. And you see here, his assistants, Dharma and Citra Gupta, and they're the ones pushing them into hell, sending them to heaven. So in heaven they live in mansions, they live peacefully, and in hell they are forever tortured. Oh, what a happy place. So this is the churning of the ocean of milk, which is one of the famous, the most famous of the Angkor Wat. There's a giant serpent, and the good side, if you will, the Asuras is pulling on the snake, and on the other side are the devils, while the angels, the Apsaras, sing encouragement. And in the middle, which is sadly being restored, and so we can't see it, is Vishnu and all of the other gods. It represents the sea, the ocean.
Angels coming over.
Maybe. But they have Mount Mandala, which is in a lot of the folklore, is in the center, and the snake's wrapped around it, so the pulling of the good and the evil twists the mountain and churns up the ocean of milk, which produces the elixir of life. And in the story, the gods win, the good gods, and they all drink lemonade. But sadly, it's being restored, so we can't actually see that. But I'll show you the other side, though. So I don't know how much you can see, but this is a sort of a photograph in place of what we can't see. But this is the churning, so that's what I showed you just before. Here's the middle, the Mount Mandala. And there's a turtle down there, which is Vishnu in the form of the turtle. And he's using himself as the pivot point for Mount Mandala and the tug of war between the bad side and the good side. So there's a bit of a consolation, but yeah.